and on a judge's salary. Well, you must have been saving your pennies for years.
Prodigal daughter returns. It is you, isn't it? You'll pardon me for not being sure, because the last time I saw you, you had on 4 pounds of makeup and your hair was orange.
Same old dad. Knows just how to put somebody at ease. I doubt that you give a damn, but I have managed to straighten out my life.
Well, be that as it may, you'll have to excuse me. I have an appointment.
Oh? You think you're going to get your precious little book back, don't you? Well, take a little advice from your devoted daughter. Alfie Cates won't just give you your book back that easily. No, he's going to bleed you for every penny that he can get.
Is that so?
You and I have a little unfinished business to take care of.
Well?
I want to talk about my mother. I already know that you murdered her. I want you to tell me why you did it.
She fell. That's all there was to it.
Oh, was it? Was it just a coincidence then that she happened to find that book of yours on the very same day that she died? That's right, Daddy. See, I saw her with it. She was in the bedroom and she was crying, and I asked her why she was so upset, but she was too proud to tell me. To tell me how the nice, comfortable world that you had built for her was suddenly crashing down around her feet. Her entire marriage to you was nothing but a damn stinking lie.
Shut up! You don't know what you're talking about.
Don't I? She confronted you, didn't she? She threatened to expose you for the low life that you are, and for that she paid the price.
Now you're going to prove she's right by exposing me yourself. You'll resurrect her ghost and get your revenge at the same time. How efficient. But it's a small problem, isn't it? That's right, the book. You don't have it. You don't have a shred of evidence to back up your little theory. I'm afraid there's nothing you can do, my dear. Nothing at all.
I'm going to kill you for what you've done.
Don't be a fool.
I'm going to shoot you.
You are not.
Yes, I am.
You can't shoot a man in cold blood.
Some can. You put that gun down and you leave. Now!
Kingsley, the judge's daughter.
Now, that's real warm, Eileen. Running a number on your own father, was that your idea, or did Alfie here get real persuasive and convince you to turn on him?
Alfie? No, Alfie didn't have to convince me of anything. My upstanding father did it all by himself.
Get in the back.
Oh, wait a second.
Let go of me!
The errand boy wants to hear about how you two cooked up this blackmail scheme.
Blackmail?
I told you to shut up and beat it!
We never talked about blackmail, Alfie!
We? Oh, no, honey. There was never any we. It was me. I would have dumped you a long time ago if it hadn't been for that book.
But you said that you loved me.
You think I could love some trashy slut like you?
You!
You all right?
I have to go down to the station and formally give them a statement, but it looks like I can go.
You know where?
Not yet. I think I'll stay with my friend Annie for a few days, and then, I don't know, we've been talking about maybe getting out and starting over. Maybe Philadelphia. She's got some family there.
I'll do good.
Thank you.